After a lot of requests from our last video on all assassins' weaknesses, we made this video for helping you to counter all heroes who are purely fighters. And we all know how annoying a good fighter enemy can be, right? But worry not, after watching this video, you will surely find comfort in handling them. So make sure to subscribe to our channel right now. A special shout out to Husfin, Pain, Mr. Creamy, I Am Not Dream and Mr. Bacon from our previous video. If you want to be in their place, press the bell icon so you will be the early commenters like them. And with that, let's roll the intro. Aldous is the strongest hero in the late game, so picking heroes with early damage and good poking should be your priority. CC heroes like Franco, Chu, Martis, etc. are pretty good against him too. So wait for his second skill to get over and jump on him with your team by giving damage and stuns to kill him fastly. Alpha is one of those heroes whose sustain relies on their spell vamp skill. His regen and damage are mostly in his second skill to try to dodge it as much as possible. Remember to keep two things in your mind. First, to keep distance from Alpha, and second is to make anti-heal items like Necklace of Durance, Sea Halberd or Dominance S. Countering Argus is simple if you keep these three things in your mind. After making a little distance from him, don't move a lot if he hits you from his second skill. It will make your HP drain faster and give him a speed buff. The second is to try poking him until he turns his ultimate on and wait in a safer distance till his ult gets over. After that, Argus will be easy enough to be killed by your team. Aulus is more like a Tarizla but a bit faster in doing everything. Making anti-heal items will be the best thing to counter his sustain because he is mostly relying on spell vamp just like the majority of fighters. But apart from that, using CC heroes is also super good to counter his high attack speed damage. Badang is a hero whose primary damage comes from his ultimate, and his damage is only fatal enough to kill you when you got hit by his second skill. So for firstly, try not to pick non-mobile heroes against him like Layla or Hanabi. And secondly, have a flicker or purify spell before going in game for dodging his second skill. If you manage to escape it, he is pretty weak to sustain your damage. Bahman is pretty strong right now due to the new Vorex item, but it can be countered if you keep your distance from him. This is an essential thing to do because his regen only works if he sticks to you. So heroes who can distance him or push him away like Johet, Chu or Leslie are good. Martis and high CC heroes are good too. Just don't forget to make anti-heal items against him. A pro Chu player can not only poke you, but he can also bait and kill you in no time. That's why if he is in your lane, always be attentive to bushes and minimap. Make sure to have purify in your spell just in case if he uses his ultimate with flicker on you. Dairoth is rarely picked due to less CC and low damage. But if someone knows how to manage his skill for regen, Dairoth can be deadly. So have your CC heroes ready and make sure to dodge his ultimate if he is marking you. And once his ult is over, you can kill him but from a distance for not giving him lifesteal. Freya's ultimate expands her range to catch you with shield and slow effect. So for avoiding that, make sure to have your flicker or purify spell ready. Just like Argus, stunning her is the best thing you can do to kill her. Guinevere is a mobile but squishy hero with magic damage. Her second skill is a core thing to initiate any damage given from her. So keep your speakers on, because hearing her second skill can be very handy for you to dodge it. And don't forget to have anti-heal item in your team for breaking her lifesteal. Johet is very tricky hero to handle, especially when he's in your lane. He can throw you, hit you with burst and can run away with shield and speed buff in no time. So keep your distance maintained from him and wait for the mid to late game, because his late game damage is manageable as compared to his serious early damage. Just like Johed, Khalid is also early game damaging hero. So if any Khalid player plays aggressively, play defensive for a while. You can start pushing him when you get your core items and anti-heal for handling his regen. His second skill is a core for his sustain, so try to give him a stun while he's using his regen skill. Leomord's ultimate is the only thing you should worry about. Because without his horse, handling him is pretty easy. And make sure to have CC heroes if he jumps in a team fight with his ult. And try not to get close to him in low health so you will not trigger his passive. Martis is a hero who can immune to all CC effects if he is using his second skill. So you can pick Sylvana, whose ult is pretty effective when it comes to grabbing him in one place. Also, his sustain depends on his spell vamp, so make sure to make anti-heal items for him. Masha is a hero who can push towers and take objectives in no time. So having map sense is very crucial for handling her. A good Masha player always waits for a moment to push towers or take Lord and turtles because she is very weak in team fights. Mincitar is one of the most underrated counters for assassin with his high mobility. His first skill is like Franco's hook and he can then trap you in his anti-dashing ultimate. To avoid that, make sure to get purify spell because flicker won't work in his ult and make sure to give him damage from a distance. Because he is tanky but not so strong when it comes to giving you damage back. Pakito is a hero who can be aggressive from early to late games. But handling his late game is a bit easy. Because of his constant dashes, CC and shield are hard to compete in the early game. That's why make sure to have a hero who can stun him like Franco, Kaja or other CC heroes. Fovius is counter of all heroes who can blink or dash. Because he can jump right onto you from his ult whenever you dash. That's why try to be more attentive to your positioning so that you can jump into a safe place ASAP. Because if you manage to get him away from his team and closer to yours, he will be dead in no time. Because Fovius lacks escaping skill and can only initiate. Maybe that is why players don't pick him a lot even though he is a new hero. Sylvana has a strong shield and regen skills. But it's easy to dodge it because her second skill is the main source of her damage. So try to roam in a circle if she caught you in her ult for avoiding her regen and damage. And if she uses her second skill, try to kill her with CC and damage as soon as possible. Sea Halberd, Dominance Ace and Necklace of Durance are the best items for ruining her lifesteal. Sun is currently in meta because of his OP revamp. His second skill comes faster and his real body is harder to find. For avoiding that, you can enable your hero lock button so you will only hit the real Sun. Taking area damaging heroes like Exvok, Sylvana or Thamuz are good against him. Thamuz can give constant true damage from his passive. And sustain depends on his spell vamp, which increases as soon as he enables his ult. But his tankiness can be countered by using CC heroes who have suppressing skills like Kaja or Franco. They can stop him from using his skills and can kill him in no time. Don't forget to pick anti-heal items to make the process faster. Terizla is one of the tankiest fighter in-game. His tankiness increases if his health goes down. That's why for penetration, using item like DHS or Malefic Roar is good against him. You can also use anti-heal item so he will die faster. Exvok is currently in meta due to his constant true damaging skills from his passive. He can be tanky and give instant damage at the same time. And with that, he can also do jungling. For killing him, checking heroes with insane burst damage like Eudora, Veil, etc. are good. Using heroes who can stun him while your team drain his shield is better. Just make sure to maintain distance or else his true damage with slowing effect will not let you escape. Yuzhong is also a fighter whose sustain relies on his spell vamp. That's why taking anti-healing items should be your first priority. After that, you should always be aware if his ultimate is on, because he becomes more deadly in his dragon state. You should keep in mind that don't let him hit you more than 5 to 6 times in a row or passive will be triggered, which will take your HP and give him regen at the same time. That's it for today. I hope you find this video helpful. If you like our content, make sure to subscribe to this channel. We upload daily, so keep your bell icon on so you won't miss any update from us. I will see you guys in the next video. Till then, keep supporting Kazuki Official. Now we will go back home today, until the very last hour. We still got few more days to slay, it's gonna get so much louder. Now we're here to take control over your body and over your soul. We're gonna take back everything and lose it all. Lose it all, lose it all.